In number three, we're going to continue to find the volume of a pyramid, but this one is a hexagonal pyramid. So that means that we're going to have to use the area of a regular polygon. So let's start with writing out volume is equal to 1/3 times the area of the base times the height. You should always start with writing out your formula. You want to make sure you pay attention to if you're doing pyramids or prisms. In this one, we're doing a pyramid. Then I'm going to take it to the next step and I'm going to say, okay, what is the area formula for my base? Since this base is a hexagon, we're going to use the area formula that is 1/2 times apothem times perimeter. And then we'll multiply that times the height of the pyramid. Now, the height of the pyramid, that's simple. They tell us it's 8. What's a little tricky is figuring out the area of the hexagon. So we are told that the base edge length is 10. So what I'm going to do on my picture is I'm just going to label that's 10. Well, that leads us to be able to find the perimeter pretty easily. There are 6 sides in a hexagon, so 10 times 6 is 60. The problem is we need to find the apothem. So I'm going to, in my picture, draw the center of the hexagon. Here's the apothem, and I'm going to make my right triangle just like we did in chapter 11. Label that A, the apothem, and because the side length is 10, I know that that side of the triangle is 5. Central angle, 360 divided by 6, and then divide that by 2 will give you the angle of this triangle, which is 30 degrees. So we know we're dealing with a 30, 60, 90 triangle. Therefore, if this is side of the triangle is 5, then the apothem would have to equal 5√3. So now I'm going to plug all of this into the formula. 1/3 times 1/2 times 5√3 times 60 times 8. Notice back in the directions that we want to keep it exact. When I multiply 1/3 times 1/2, multiply fractions, it is 1/6. And if I multiply 5 times 60 times 80, we get 2400√3. And so then if I do 2400 divided by 6, I get 400√3, and that is cubic units. Number 4 is a regular triangular pyramid. When it is a regular triangle, that means that it's equilateral. So when I do the volume for this pyramid, it's going to be 1/3 times the area of the base times the height. And because this triangle is equilateral, I'm going to use my formula 1/4 times s squared, the side squared, times √3 times the height of the pyramid. And this turns into a fairly straightforward problem. We know that the base edge of the triangle is 12, and we know the height is 10. So if I plug those values in, 1/3 times 1/4 times 12 to the second power, √3 times 10, we know that 12 to the second power is 144. So if we take the fractions, 1/3 times 1/4 is 1/12, times 144√3 times 10. And then in your calculator, 144 times 10 is 1,440. Divide that by 12 and it turns out you just get 120. Don't forget to attach the √3 and your cubic units. Now, by the way, this one didn't ask us to give exact. I would just go ahead and leave it as exact, but if you wanted to enter this into your calculator and give the approximate answer, that would be okay, because in this problem they don't tell you to either give exact or approximate. Number 5 is a little bit tricky, so let's take a look at number 5. Find the approximate volume of a regular pentagonal pyramid given an apothem of 3 and a slant height of 5. So, again, I'm going to start my problem by writing out the volume formula, 1/3 times the area of the base times the height. In this case, because we are working with a base that's a pentagon, we're going to have to do 1/2 times apothem times perimeter. And then we're going to have to multiply by the height of the pyramid, which leads to our first issue. The first issue is we don't know the height. We know the slant height, but we don't know the height. So take your picture and draw in the slant height, and then also draw where your height would be, and what you should see as a result is a right triangle. And if I know that this is 5, and if you can recognize that this right here is the same as the apothem, which is, sorry, that's a weird 3, which is 3, they told us the apothem is 3, then we can use Pythagorean theorem to find the height of this pyramid. So h squared plus 3 squared equals 5 squared, and if you solve for h, you should get a height of 4. So we've got the height of the pyramid. The next problem we run into is we know the apothem, but we don't know the perimeter of the pentagon. And so what we're going to do is we're going to draw, just like we would if we were finding the area of a pentagon, I am going to draw another right triangle, but this time I'm going to draw from the center of the pentagon to the base, and my apothem I know is 3. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to find this piece of the triangle. So we're going to have to involve the central angle. The central angle, remember, is 360 divided by 5, which is 72 degrees. And then you have to take that in half, 72 divided by 2, to get this angle right here, which is 36 degrees. So if I have a right triangle with an angle of 36 degrees, in order to find x, I'm going to have to use SOHCAHTOA. So because I have x and 3, that's going to involve tangent. So the tan of 36 equals opposite, which is x, over adjacent, which is 3. And if I put that in my calculator, 3 times the tangent of 36 degrees should be about 2.2. Now remember, in the directions we are approximating, so it's fine to round. Now if x is 2.2, I need to multiply that by 2 to get the side length. So 2.2 times 2 is 4.4. And the whole reason for doing this is we had to figure out the perimeter of the pentagon. So 5 sides times 4.4 is 22. So now I have the perimeter, I have the apothem of 3, and we have found the height. Oops, that's not the height, sorry. We found the height, which is 4. Then we can finish the problem. 1/3 times 1/2 times apothem of 3 times perimeter of 22 times the height of 4. And if we plug this into our calculator, it is going to give us an approximate answer of 44 cubic units.